Hello, I'm Daniel Berio. I'm a research associate at Goldsmiths, University of London, and I will present our paper, Stroke Styles, Stroke-Based Segmentation and Stylization of Fonts. I've co-authored this paper with Frederic for Leymarie, also based at Goldsmiths, and with Paul Asente and Jose Echevarria at Adobe Research. Our main goal is to start from fonts in order to generate stylizations that resemble art forms such as calligraphy or traditional graffiti art. Calligraphy and graffiti tagging, itself a form of urban calligraphy, are intrinsically stroke-based. Here, strokes are marks left by a writing instrument following the trajectory of a skillful hand gesture. Also in more complex and outline-based forms of graffiti art, stylized letters are often constructed with building blocks similar to strokes. In this case, strokes assume a solid shape and are then assembled, fused, and outlined along a letter structure, finally producing highly stylized compositions of letter forms. This process can be easily be verified by observing the sketching process behind some graffiti pieces. In recent years, we have been busy studying and deconstructing graffiti art and calligraphy, and we have developed methods and tools that enable a user to quickly design graffiti stylized letters using parametric stroke primitives that can be sketched along the structure of a letter. Our method enables us to recover these structures from font outlines by segmenting those into strokes and their topological relations. Our method is designed to work on glyphs that have a meaningful and recoverable stroke structure, and not, for example, on glyphs that are made of decorative elements. Given a stroke decomposition, one can apply stylizations at the stroke level by changing the way in which the strokes are rendered, or one can apply structural level stylizations, which operate on the stroke center line and then can be rendered with different types of stroke primitives, in order to achieve more dramatic stylization results. Our method is based on perceptual principles and geometric procedures. It does not require training data, which is largely absent for the use case of Western fonts, or templates that would break for the large variety of languages, styles, and writing systems that are present in fonts. Most existing works that generate stylized text are either outline or image-based, or rely on either user guidance or templates to recover a stroke structure from a glyph outline. Our method is different from most of those, as it uses an automatic stroke decomposition to produce structure-based stylizations. Automatic stroke decomposition is more common with East Asian characters, which have a very well-defined stroke structure with extensive data sets for data-driven methods. However, these methods do not work well with Western fonts, which do not have ground truth data and often blend components in ways that make segmentation more challenging. Our solution is instead closely related to methods that decompose object silhouettes into parts. While object part decomposition obviously also depends on domain knowledge, psychophysical results suggest that perceptual grouping and part segmentation are processes that largely occur preattentively, or at least very early in the vision process. We rely on a number of relevant perceptual and geometric principles that have been studied in the literature to drive our segmentation without requiring training data. In a nutshell, our method starts from the interior and exterior medial axis of a glyph outline. We use the medial axis to compute a set of curvilinear shape features that capture concavities and convexities along the outline. We then associate pairs of concavities with line segments that we call links, which represent locations where stroke potentially cross or overlap. We then use these features to categorize the branching structure of the interior medial axis into a set of junctions that characterize semantic stroke features and segment the interior medial axis into a set of strokes. We use these strokes as a basis for a variety of path-based glyph stylizations. Curvature extrema, especially concavities, play an important role in the perception of shape and its decomposition into parts. We characterize concave and convex outline features with curvilinear shape features, which I will call CSFs for short. Each CSF consists of a curvature extrema or corner, its corresponding circle of curvature, a contact region at which curvature is approximately constant, and two support segments extending until the next CSF. We identify initial set of CSFs through the interior and exterior medial axis of the outline. This set is not necessarily complete, so we proceed with identifying the remaining CSFs with a simple iterative procedure that computes local medial axis. Please refer to the paper for more details. CSFs capture concavities and convexities along the outline, while also facilitating the computation of features that are useful for stroke segmentation. For example, the interior skeletal segments that are symmetric to the contact region of a concave CSF give us ligatures, regions that are indicative of perceptually distinct parts, and will eventually need adjustment when reconstructing strokes. The CSF support segments facilitate the computation of tangents near concavities, which we then use to compute a measure of good continuation along disjoint outline segments. For this task, we use a perceptually inspired method by Ernst et al., which gives us an association field between two tangents. The field decays with distance between the tangents and deviations from cocircularity of one tangent with the next. Similarly to many part decomposition methods, we formulate segmentation hypotheses by joining pairs of concavities with line segments. Here we call these line segment links. One single link defines a potential incidence relation between one stroke and another. Then pairs of links with good continuation along the outline define regions where one stroke potentially crosses another one. With links and CSFs in hand, we proceed with the definition of a set of junctions, semantic features that will determine how the interior medial axis is transformed into strokes by joining or discarding branches or adjusting medial axis regions, usually identified with ligatures. We define a taxonomy of 7 junction types that we found to be sufficient for our task of glyph stylization. Half junctions define a stroke crossing a region of the glyph by joining two medial axis branches delimited by two links that have high good continuation. As an example, two crossing strokes will be produced by two half junctions. But these junctions often appear in more complex configurations consisting of more than two half junctions and resulting in the same number of crossing strokes. T junctions define one stroke incident to another by separating one branch delimited by a link and joining two incident branches into one stroke. Y junctions define a region where one stroke branches out of another pair, which is joined into one stroke. L junctions define a corner or an elbow-like feature by joining two branches and discarding a hierarchy of branches considered non-salient. Stroke ends discard a hierarchy of branches indicative of a square-like end of a stroke. Protuberances identify a relatively short stroke or the continuation of one delimited by a link, and a middle axis branch configuration similar to a stroke end. Finally, null junctions identify and discard medial axis branches that are not significant to the stroke reconstruction of a glyph. Note that L junctions, stroke ends, protuberances, and null junctions effectively prune the medial axis while also taking stroke semantics into account. We identify junctions with an iterative procedure that operates on a stroke graph, having one vertex for each medial axis branch. Adding an edge to the stroke graph joins two branches into one stroke, while discarding a vertex removes a branch. Once this procedure is terminated, we have the inferred stroke decomposition of the outline. We tested our method on hundreds of fonts, and in most cases, it produces plausible segmentations. However, the method is, of course, not free of limitations. The junction classification procedure expects the existence of predefined structures in the medial axis. These structures can break, for example, in very thick glyphs when stroke thickness becomes larger than stroke length. Another limitation concerns East Asian characters. Here, a correct stroke decomposition is fundamental, but not always recoverable from geometric use. An example of this can be seen in the Japanese word Tokyo, in which the box-like features should always result into three strokes. If we examine the sans serif glyphs for the same word, their outline does not contain geometric features that could possibly lead to a correct segmentation without applying domain knowledge. Given the availability of ground truth data for this domain, this invites the future inclusion of data-driven component in the junction identification stage. Now moving on to stylization. Let's start with examples of the nonsense word Hamburger fonts, which is commonly used to assess the character of a font. In the simplest form of stylization, we use skeletal strokes to construct various types of graphic stylizations. We can also use spines to easily create animations of a glyph, a process that would usually require the tedious process of tracing the spines by hand. Things get more interesting when we start applying stylizations at the structural level. One method that we found to be particularly effective for our use case is a C-oriented schematization, a method that is common for generating metro map layouts and transforms spines into polylines with quantized orientations. While the schematization method we use that does not take incidence relations into account, junctions give us an easy way to recover and rectify those. The schematized spines are sparse polygons that can be used as a motor plan to guide the evolution of smooth trajectories that mimic the ones that could be performed by human hand when writing or drawing. This allows a range of stylizations that combine variations of schematization parameters with variations of trajectory generation parameters. We can then use this combination to produce a variety of stylizations that can resemble calligraphy. Of course, these trajectories can also be animated with addition of drips where the trajectory speed is particularly low. The same schematized spines can be used to assemble strokes that mimic the appearance of graffiti letters. We then use a local layering procedure we have developed to construct the outlines, add extrusion effects, and finally add fill-ins and highlights similar to the ones that can be seen in graffiti art. Again, this method provides a large parameter space that can be explored by a user to generate a variety of stylizations of a given string. While our focus has been graffiti and calligraphy, it turns out that the stroke decomposition can be useful for many other applications. For example, we can use junctions to segment the glyph outline into parts, compute similarities among those parts, and then let a user design replacements for similar parts, which are then used to consistently stylize a string. A similar process can also be done with animations. Stroke segmentation has many other use cases, for example, producing particle-based animations of a string, or producing abstract animated glyphs. To conclude, we have seen how a stroke decomposition of fonts is a challenging problem with a lack of training data and a huge variety of letter shapes and styles that can often lead to ambiguous segmentation hypotheses. But a solution is feasible by relying solely on geometric and perceptual principles. And this solution can be extremely useful to produce a variety of text-based stylizations and animations. In the future, we plan to explore alternative approaches that build on our feature sets as CSFs and junctions, and to include a data-driven element to the junction identification stage. Another interesting avenue of experimentation is to use our segmentations to train sequence generation methods, such as SketchRNN or others. Thanks for your attention.